Hello again, you're with us here on Aspire. Now, if you've been to New York and not gone for a Broadway musical, it would indeed be a crying shame. Some of the best musicals have been converted into films. They're very big out there. Here's a look at some of them. Dazzling lights, flashing colors, stunning dancers, unforgettable music, and of course, all that jazz. That's what Broadway has always been about. Theatrical extravaganzas, whether they are classic love stories like Moulin Rouge or Phantom of the Opera, dramas like Chicago, or comedies like Hairspray. Or perhaps just timeless tales like Wicked and Cats. Broadway musicals have captivated audiences for decades. Their staggering success has prompted many Hollywood directors to make movies based on these musicals, and they too have gone on to become hugely popular. But musicals haven't really quite made it to Indian tastes. For a country that has always seen the Bollywood kind of masala in its films, musicals, as theatrical spectacles, have been largely missing from the entertainment scene. Though this has possibly changed it. Zangura, the Gypsy Prince. Strung together with all-time favorite Bollywood songs, the story explores a larger-than-life world, full of magic, music, dance, color, and all things Bollywood. Is Zangura, though, as good as it gets by way of musicals in India? Or can we expect our musicals to match the magic of theater as seen on Broadway or even the West End? To find out, I meet Rohan Sippy, directing his first musical that's to play out first in Delhi, even though the musical itself is set in 60s Mumbai.
Rohan, first things first, why haven't we seen too many musicals here in India?
I don't know. It's a good question. We love music and we love this kind of drama and theatre. So I think, I know in Bombay there's always a challenge with spaces and they're not easy to pull off. I think you also need a talent pool of actors who can sing or singers who can act and dance and musicians who are also ready to go live with everything. So
one more thing, that this is the place where you'd find all of them, because their actors more or less have been dancers and singers and, you know.
Yeah, but there's been very little tradition of actors singing their own songs, right, so far.
I mean, that's right, but it started off like that.
Yeah, it did. And somewhere it kind of, there were other ways to do it, and then I guess...
No, but considering that our films have so much song and dance, you know, it's surprising that we haven't caught on to what happens in a Broadway or a West End.
Yeah, absolutely. I think, I've realized in the course of this that it's not easy to pull these things off, which is part of it, and you need a huge commitment of time and resources to do these kind of things. So it's never going to be easy.
Yes.
And you need the kind of spaces that will then allow them to be enjoyed again and again. You know, like in the West End, you have several theatres that are permanently running plays, and we don't have that yet. So, you know, there in the West, you know that, okay, someone invests in a play, there's a good chance if it's a good play, it'll run for a considerable amount of time.
But what does it take for a filmmaker like yourself to be able to catch on to the idea of, let's do a musical? Where does the idea come from? And, you know, what we're seeing behind us right now, the rehearsal for which is going on, we're going to see the performance, and we're going to see whether or not this actually lives up to what we have seen on Broadway and West End. But tell us, where does the idea come from?
That's very far away. Obviously, we don't have, we don't even begin to compare ourselves to that.
We hope you're being modest.
No, it's true.
You know, all our actors lip sync to other great singers. Whereas in the West, if you do Broadway, you are required to sing and dance and sing your own songs.
That's me. He promised me a necklace.
It's the lead of the play now entering as far as this musical is concerned. This, of course, is the last rehearsal before the performance happens tonight. We'll see exactly how it goes on to the performance.
You've actually made it better.
There's only a sliver of a story. Small town guy with big dreams, a honey voiced seductress that small town guy falls in love with, a gun toting gangster who runs a nightclub called Venice.
What's the deal with this guy who owns this place?
Mera naam chin chin chu, chin chin chu, baba chin chin chu. That's Johnny Bandu. Hello, Mr. How do you do?
I won't go back to jail, Benny. Not for you, not for her, and not for the Venice.
Joe, don't lose the dream.
I think what we see in Bollywood are false musicals because they're not really, the actors don't really sing, and there's this dichotomy between who sings and who mimes and who's on front of screen. I think that's set to change.
You know, the very first thing is that we don't have a theater to match that. What's really missing is lack of infrastructure. India is known to do larger than life thing, so there's no way we can't do a grand. This wasn't grand if you want to compare it to Broadway.
The fact that film has become such a huge mass phenomenon, bringing people in to watch the same kind of thing live, you know, maybe people are hesitant, but I think it's just something that people have kind of not thought about. And hopefully this and other things that might happen similar to this will open that avenue out, because I think it's something that can go across language, across different cultures, within our country, I mean, and it can be used beautifully, because in each culture, each region, we have amazing local music, local dancing, so you can use that so much. I mean, we could probably be the most creative with musicals in India, given the kind of culture we have.
On a chilly evening in Delhi, we get to see a performance that was not bad by most standards, and most of the audience members liked it. The singing, well, not the best, but they did okay for themselves. The acting, also not so great, but the spectacle, at least the effort, the costumes, the kind of stage that we saw, nothing compared to the standards set by the Broadways and the West Ends of the world, but still not too bad, and perhaps only fitting that it had to end with a tribute to Bombay, the city of dreams. Bombay. If you're looking for a watch that would be a collector's piece, we're suggesting a Brigade this time. Stay tuned.